Crossing the Bar is the poem written by Alfred Lord Tennyson, who was the most renowned poet of the Victorian era. Tennyson wrote this poem in 1889 at the age of 81 when he was seriously ill. He died after 3 years. Naturally, death and dying is the main theme of this short meditative poem. The demarcation between the harbor and the ocean is symbolic of life and death, and the metaphor of a sandbar, a ridge of sand built up by currents along a shore, is used to describe the barriers between life and death in the poem. Let us go to the poem. The first stanza. Sunset and evening star, and one clear call for me, and may there be no morning of the bar when I put out to sea. Here we see that a ship is getting ready to sail at the sunset on a long voyage. As the sun descends, the light of the evening star, that is planet Venus, rises to act like a beacon light of the mariners. In the first line we see sunset and evening star. Sunset here stands for end of life, and the poet is waiting for his call, that is death. The ship will sail out of the harbor, across the sandbar at the harbor's entrance and into the sea without much noise and only low murmur of the sea. Here the journey across the bar is symbolic of the crossing from the harbor of life into the dark unknown sea or afterlife. And the clear call is the call of impending death. The speaker hopes for a gentle crossing out of harbor or the sandbar that separates the harbor from sea, that is life and death. Now let us see the second stanza of the poem. But such a tide as moving seems asleep, too full for sound and form, when that which drew from out the boundless deep turns again home. Here the poet laments that the tide that facilitates the ship crossing the bar seems calm and quiet. The movement is very slow. He says the tide that develops deep in the ocean with the roaring sound and high waves returns home gently. It means that the speaker's soul returned into eternity, just as tide returned to the depths of the ocean, silently, with no turbulence, and he feels the journey into death is merely a part of a cycle of birth and death. Now let us see the third stanza of the poem. Twilight and evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. Old age and impending death, and thereafter darkness all over. And he says that no one should be unhappy or sad at the time of his death. He hopes for cheerful departure when he embarks on a new journey of afterlife. And the fourth stanza of the poem. For though from out our bourne of time and place, the flood may bear me afar, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar. Here in the last stanza of the poem, The poet says that the tide may take him far beyond the limits of time and place. Once he crosses the bar, and there he would meet face to face with his pilot. That is God, the Creator. After crossing the bar that separates the harbor and the sea, this journey would lead him far beyond the limits of time and place, where he would be able to see God face to face. So, through this poem, the poet wants to convey that death is not something to be feared, but face it calmly and cheerfully. Have faith in God and prepare for life after death, because our soul is eternal.